Hello everyone, welcome back to another pastel video, and we're back with more meadows and flowers. I don't really know if you want to call this one meadow, to be honest. It's more like weeds. Weeds in a field, but same thing really. So I'm going to use another piece of my, or the other piece of the Made Tents Touch dark brown, which I used previous video. It's just that I cut it in half, so I'm going to use the other half now. So yeah, you can hear this is a sanded, smooth sanded paper. And I'm going to do something a bit more portrait. My reference image is very landscape, so I'm going to take a kind of slice of it and do it that way, just to give us a bit more kind of height and verticalness, which I'm really looking forward to do. And I also want to bring the perspective down a bit, so I have the flowers coming up higher with, I'm going to say less background, but more of the foreground coming into the top of the section of the painting. So we're going to start with our underpainting, which I'm going to do with my usual favourite selection of blues and whatnots. The dark blue. Right. I really want to, because I'm bringing this in and down, you won't see any sky. So there'll be no sky, which is fine. It's kind of what I want. Probably going to have to use some fixative on this as well, but we'll see. And I want to bring the flowers up here. Now, there's no point in me mapping out in this case the flowers of where I'm going to put them. It's just too complicated because there's too many small flowers to be able to do that without the blue going over the top of it anyway. I do want the background to come quite far down. And I want to do my usual where I frame it, so I bring it in. So I'll bring the dark down at the edges, so that it forces the viewer in. I want a little bit. So dark in the corner and up. Dark in the corner and up. So that gives us our main lighter focal point, but we are bringing the flowers up. Let's see. It is not pouring with rain, but it has been raining pretty much all night now and all day. So for the classically standard wet day here. I don't want this to be, too dark, so I'm going to use a mid-tone green for here. A little bit lighter than I wanted, if I might. That's fine. Reason being that I'm going to get a lot of the food up, so it doesn't matter too much, I think, going that way. Right, that's the underpainting done. Well, the base part of the underpainting. I might use my scraggly brush actually for this. It's just a, there you go, home base paintbrush. Nothing complicated. I'm just going to spray this down. Is going to interrupt. I'm quite happy to let this run. I'm not fussed about it running. In fact, in some ways I almost want it to run. Right, and I'm going to let that dry. Okay, so underpainting is now dry, and you can kind of see where we're going with this. So now I'm going to reinforce the darks and do a bit more work on the background, because I want to spray that, which will darken it again slightly, just so that we can then focus on down here. So I'm going to start with my favourite blue. Too much down here because it's already quite a nice dark layer down here anyway, so I'm just gonna put that in slightly. Just nice up and down strokes because that's where we want. In some blue greens and stuff, so I'm not too fussed at the moment. Trying to find the right, because that's a bit light, isn't it? If you want to go, so you keep that on the side. Grab this, which is our darker colour. See, there's trees in the background and they're pretty much in shade, so bring that down a little bit. Just wanna add some of this to this down here. I want to add some of my lighter greens in. The reason for this is I want to bring the focus into the middle. Yes, it's unusual because usually you want to draw the eye elsewhere, but in this case, I'm going to bring it in slightly. Because I want to cool it off because it's in the distance. So a bit like that. I also want to do cooler at the tips of the green. Because where it's in the distance. Looking suitably messy. I want to bring in some lighter blues though. Just a little bit more. I'm going to do some vibrant. I want to still keep it cool tone. This might actually be. This is a lovely colour. Just. Some light to the shadow, which also really sounds weird, but I know what I mean. Like the shadow is this cool blue background, but at the same time, there is lighter parts to a shadow and darker parts. quite like that actually. Yeah, stick with that for a minute. Let's spray that down though. Using my ever trusty fixative, which is Weller Silvicrin? That's what it's called. Use this firm hold. You know, you want it firm. Not the maximum hold, accordingly. Maybe I should try number 5. Definitely use this stuff in a well ventilated space. Because yeah, it's pretty strong, but as a fixative, works great. So, just gonna let that dry. Right, now that that's dry, let's start working on grasses and things. So, I've got a lot of kind of greens in there, but we've got a lot of golds in the background as well, actually. So I think it might be worth starting with a kind of gold colour. I'm going to go something a bit more neutral. So that's probably going to be too light. See, in between all the grasses, there is quite a lot of this kind of yellow gold colour. So we're gonna, yeah, I don't want to take it up too far because it does not go up. It kind of stays in the middle band across here. This is from a new pastel, so it's a harder pastel. It's kind of what I want. See, I'm just using kind of the edge of this new pastel to kind of get in some of the blades of grass. Yeah, that's looking lovely. Like that is nice. Start getting in these more darker tone greens that we've got over the top before I start working out grasses and also where we want to put other things. That's a darker brown. Do I want any darker brown in there? I might come back to that colour. Maybe look at that later. I also have this, which is another darker brown green as well. we're just using it to kind of same as everything else. Clean it up. Clean it off the edge of the page, slightly. Like that. Some of these darker greens. This is going to be darker than the that's a grey green. Nice, but not what I want. I haven't really got any of the vivid yellow greens in yet either, but that's probably because I want to get this other one in. Yeah, this one will do. We just want it kind of bringing in. There's from the darker colours that we've got going on. So where we've got our blues, I can bring it up from where the blues are. Here's where it makes sense. And then I'm going to bring some of the blue back in, just because it will add see straight away, it just adds that extra depth that you wouldn't get otherwise. Always going in the direction you want your grasses to go. Like that. Yeah, that's looking really, really lovely. Now, before I go any further with the grasses and stuff, do want to get in these flowers. So we've got these little buttercups. We've also got these little, kind of little, almost star-shaped. I'm gonna zoom in. I can't tell. Yeah, they're kind of like four little petals. So, kind of want to give different colours. So I want to kind of blue, grey, and a green, grey. This is a purple, this is a violet. Actually, that might work. A bit of violet. So this is a neutral violet. There it is. See it there? So it might actually be quite good. Now, the little white ones are actually low level, so they're not, none of those actually go high, they're all, fairly low. I'm just kind of making little cross marks. Smaller dots here and there where I want them. Like that. Lovely. They are a kind of pinky colour. It's almost like a kind of the white pink. I think that will do nicely for them. So I'm just gonna there's our white. We will add just a touch of violet, I think, actually. Put some on down. There. It's a bit better. There's a lot more of the yellow flowers than there is of the white ones, so. That's a bit better. I have no idea what's going on outside. It suddenly got very raggedy. Oh, there's a truck. That'll be why. Delivering tarmac on blocks. Keep moving. Down the street. Thank you. Right. I want to bring in these lighter grasses and stuff. So I've got this really beautiful kind of yellow. Too light. I think this, let's try it a minute. This might be too light. Well, I don't know actually. Maybe not. There we go. Yeah, that's looking pretty. We want it brighter in the middle. Like that. Yeah, that's looking really, really like that. They're drawn this way. I feel like I do need to put maybe the blue green, some of this blue green in. Thank you. more of a blue. We have a lot of greens. Right, we need some yellows. Now, these are very blue yellows in this. So, I'll work out what might be the best option. Because they've got a lot of green. Yeah. Oh, these have got little pop up. So the question is, what do I want to start with? That's kind of an orangey colour. Do I want to use that? Because it would be good to actually put that in. Do the neutral. Like, guys, do you have to slam doors outside my house, please? Formation. I'm sticking that one. Yeah. that's nice. Now,
that's a darker and lighter.
It's a really nice kind of orangey colours here, which should give us some tone. This really nice light cream. This light blue one, blue yellow, should give us tones and that. I think that's come out really, really well. So I'm probably just going to leave that there because I don't want to overwork it. There we go. Right. Hope you all enjoyed that little pastel painting today, and hopefully I will see you all for another one very, very soon. Ta-ta for now.